Hi, I'm Ritesh, and welcome to this course on building Mule Soft applications using Anypoint Studio. After this course, you will be able to build and deploy your own Mule applications using Anypoint Studio. Anypoint Studio is built on the popular Java Eclipse IDE. Let me start by creating a Mule application and then walking you through the various Anypoint panels and explaining their functions. In order to create a Mule Soft application, you will need to locate the file menu which is at the left-hand top corner of Anypoint Studio. Once located, click on the file menu, choose the new option, and then click on Mule Project. You'll be presented with a pop-up screen like so. Start by entering a project name. I'm calling mine as World App. One thing to note is you can't have spaces in your project name or application name. The second choice is the runtime. You can choose the default runtime, or if you need other runtimes for your project to work on, you can click on Install Runtimes and install those runtimes on your local machine and choose those alternatively instead of the default one. The last option in this screen to take note of is the default location. If you wish to have your MuleSoft application created in a different folder on your local machine, you'll need to come here and uncheck this and browse to that location. Once you're done with the screen, click on Finish. Anypoint Studio will create your application in the background with all the necessary scaffolding. Once it's finished, it is going to load the application within your IDE, like so. On the left-hand side, you have the Package Explorer. This panel will outline the structure of your application with its folders and contents of those folders. On the right-hand side, you have the Mule Palette. The Mule Palette consists of all the connectors and components available through MuleSoft. In the center is the Configuration File panel. This panel will actually load any of your configuration files. You can have one or more configuration files. In my case, I only have one configuration file, and I'll call that worldapp.xml. The center panel has three options. Message flow. This is the default view of the configuration file and is a GUI-based view. This view allows you to drag and drop containers and components onto it. The second option is Global Elements. Global Elements allows you to configure the global elements that will be available across your configuration files. The last option is Configuration XML. Configuration XML will present your Mule flows in the XML view. In the bottom, we have the following panels. Mule Properties. Use the Mule Properties panel to configure the individual components or connectors that have been dragged onto the message flow. The Problems panel will show you design time issues. The Console will show you the compilation of your project when it's being built and deployed. This window can also be used to display logs that are written to the console. The last panel is the Mule Debugger. The Mule Debugger will allow you to watch your variables when you're stepping through the code. Now that we have a basic understanding of how Anypoint Studio works and its various panels, let's go ahead and create our very first Hello World REST-based API. We can do so by going to our Mule palette and clicking on HTTP. Locate the listener and drag the listener onto your center panel. This will create your very first Mule flow. You then need to configure your listener. Let's add a configuration. Your default configuration is bound to your local IP address, but I would like to use localhost. I can do so by using the dropdown and choosing localhost. I'll leave the port as 8081, and I'll set the base path as /API. Once you're done, click on OK. Let's give this API a name. I'm going to call mine as greeting. Once done, we need to actually specify the method for this API. And you can do so by clicking Advanced and typing in the method. I'm going to allow get is the method, and you're done configuring your listener. This API has to return a response, so we'll need to create a response. To do so, head back to your Mule palette and click on Core. Scroll on the right hand side all the way down till you can find Set Payload. Then drag the Set Payload into your Mule flow, like so. I'm going to specify a response by typing in Hello World. Okay, we're all done with our very first REST-based API using Anypoint Studio. I'm going to click on the console and I'm going to start compiling and deploying this application by right-clicking anywhere in the center panel and hitting Run Project. Save it. Okay, so our application has been built and deployed successfully. You can see this in the console. And once you're done with that, the last step is to test your REST-based API. For this, I'm going to use a tool called Postman. Let's create a new tab. Set your path to the greeting API. Make sure that you use the right method, which in this case is GET. And I'm going to hit Send. And voila, there you go. You get the Hello World as your response. There you go. I hope you enjoyed this course, and watch out for more videos on MuleSoft and Anypoint Studio. Thanks for watching.